You're watching News Circle. Let's have a close look at today's important headlines. Board releases link to upload CBSE class 10 marks by schools. One dose of Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine reduces death risk by 80%. Army index first batch of women in military police. State police receive of 1.75 lakh e-pass applications. IMD warns of cyclonic storm orange alert in several Kerala districts. Board releases link to upload CBSE class 10 marks by schools. The CBSE class 10 marks upload link has been made available on the ePariksha 2021 portal. Let's know more about it.
The Central Board of Secondary Education CBSE on Monday, May 10, 2021 released the link to upload CBSE class 10 marks by schools. The CBSE class 10 marks upload link has been made available on the ePariksha 2021 portal. All the schools affiliated to the CBSE board can now upload the CBSE class and mark sheets on the official portal of ePariksha on or before June 11, 2021. As per the notification released by the board on May 1, CBSE class 10 results 2021 will be announced by June 20. The board had earlier released the marking scheme for class 10 students. CBSE class 10 students are assessed out of maximum 100 marks for each subject, in which 20 marks are for internal assessment and 80 marks for year-end examinations. However, this year the CBSE board had cancelled the annual board examination of class 10 due to COVID-19 pandemic. The board has announced the CBSE class 10 marks this year would be calculated on the basis of internal examination held by schools throughout the year. Further details related to CBSE exam and results can be checked on the official website of the board, cbse.nic.in. This is Partha Mahesh signing out from New Circle.
AstraZeneca vaccine reduces death risk by 80%. People who had a single dose of AstraZeneca vaccine were 55% protected against death. Let's know more about it.
Data from the rollout of Oxford AstraZeneca's COVID-19 vaccine shows one dose of shot results in 80% less risk of death from the disease, Public Health England said on Monday. It also said protection against death from the Pfizer biotech vaccine rises from approximately 80% after one dose to 97% after two doses in its new analysis. PHE said the study was first on protection against mortality from the AstraZeneca vaccine based on data from a real-world setting. The Serum Institute of India is manufacturing COVID Shield, a licensed version of Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine. The study looked at new symptomatic cases of COVID-19 between December and April and people who died within 28 days of their positive test by vaccination status. People who had a single dose of AstraZeneca vaccine were 55% protected against death, with a figure of 44% protection for a single dose of Pfizer compared to unvaccinated people. Combined with the protection vaccines offer against becoming a case in the first place, this is equivalent to approximately 80% protection against mortality in the individuals vaccinated with a single dose of either vaccines, PHE said in a statement. Protection against mortality from the Pfizer biotech vaccine improved to 69% for cases who had their second dose at least a week before they tested positive. Combined with the estimated protection from getting COVID-19 to start with, this is equivalent to an estimated 97% protection, PHE said. In another data set, PHE said that it was estimated that the two doses of Pfizer biotech vaccine reduced the risk of hospitalization by 93% for over the 80s. This is Pratyana Jones signing off for now. Thank you.
The government had approved the induction of women in military police in January and plans to have 1,700 women soldiers in the coming batch. Let's know more about it.
Army in the first batch of women in military police. The government had approved the induction of women in military police in January 2019 and plans to have 1,700 women soldiers by 2036 in batches of 100 recruits per year. The Indian Army inducts its first batch of 83 women soldiers as a part of its military police on Saturday. A low-key attention parade for the soldiers took place at the Dronacharya Parade ground in Bangalore. The soldiers went through an intense 61 weeks of training on aspects related to basic military training. The proposed training to include all forms of policing duties and management of prisoners of war, ceremonial duties and skill development to include driving and maintenance of all vehicles and signal communications. The government had approved the induction of women in military police in January 2019 and plans to have 1,700 women soldiers by 2036 in batches of 100 recruits per year. Thank you. This is Salome Susan George signing for now.
State police receive over 1.75 e-pass applications to travel during lockdown. Let's know more about it.
E-pass for emergency people movement. State police has facilitated the movement of individual during the second phase of lockdown through pre-approved electronic passes. Since its launch on 8 May 2021, there is a massive rush in new applications. However, the police chief, Loknath Behra, urged people to use this facility when it is extremely necessary. This is Tena Eraser Terence for New Circle from Mad Anxious School, Malappally.
Weather report. Kerala is expecting heavy rainfall from May 11th. Alerts have been issued in several districts across the state. Let's know more about it.
The Indian Meteorological Department warns of a cyclonic storm. Orange alerts have been issued in Pathanamthitta, Kollam, Thiruvananthapuram and Alappuzha, while yellow alerts have been issued in Idukki, Malappuram, Ernakulam, Kottayam and Thrissur. The cyclone is named as Tauktae, as suggested by Myanmar. Squally weather with the wind runs at a speed of 40 to 50 km per hour. Is likely to the southwest and to the adjoining Southeast Arabian Sea for the next few days. The State Disaster Management Authority has announced a complete ban for fishing off the coast of Kerala from May 14, 2021 until the further notice due to the possibility of bad weather and strong winds on sea in the connection of the formation of low pressure. The SDMA has directed the government and the public to take precautionary measures. This report is from Rafael Abraham from the news channel News Circle.
That's all for today's bulletin. This is Dinu Selenjan signing off from News Circle. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.